you?
I am great.
It's so lovely to have you here. So lovely to see you. And congratulations on the new book. It is great.
Thank you.
And you wow. write about an addiction to film, and it's kind of, you're kind of not joking around. You had an addiction.
I was horribly addicted. From like 95 to 99, my any spare moment I had, I was trying to figure out how to go see another movie in a theater. And it affected everything, sleep, health, relationships, my job. It was, it basically, it was heroin without the track marks. This is all right. It was. It was the same effect.
Easier to hide, which made it easier to continue.
Yeah, way easier to hide. Although, you know, the popcorn bloat was hard to hide after a while. That got a little sad.
So. You did lose a relationship over this, or one came to a close?
I did. I was in an all-night horror movie marathon with my then-girlfriend, and a movie named Daughter of Horror had just ended. A new one called I Married a Monster from Outer Space was about to start. It was 2 in the morning. She was tired. She says, hey, I need to go out to my car and go home. It's 2 a.m. And I go, okay, you should go then, because I don't want to miss. I didn't want to miss the beginning of I Married a Monster from Outer Space. So I made my then-girlfriend. Look, I'm doing my own intervention here, okay? Don't so walk out to her car at 2 a.m. And pretty soon she justifiably left me.
Yes.
So, yeah.
Especially at 2 in the morning after you've made her watch horror movies for God knows how many hours.
Oh, God, I even thought of that. Yeah. It was like, let's watch 5 horror movies in a row and have fun off in the darkness in the parking garage. I can't miss, if I don't see the very beginning, if I don't see every second of these movies, they don't count.
Right.
Because your boyfriend's
so was
crazy. Yeah, it was
you had an obsession.
Craziness.
This weaves in very well with where you were as a comedian then, which is the early days. And I love stories about early comedians and bombing. And you, what's the worst you bombed in your early days?
Well, okay, this is the absolute worst that I've ever had. This is beyond bombing, all right? I was in Roanoke, Virginia, doing a comedy club. The day of the show, I get the worst stomach flu of my life. Just throwing off things at both ends. We'll leave it at that. Yeah. So I did that thing where, I'm sure you've done this too before shows, you take just enough DayQuil, Dristan, Pepto-Bismol. I've got just enough health to get me. And all I was doing, I was just hosting. All I got to do is 10 minutes. I got to do 10 minutes. So I take the stuff. I've timed it just right. Ladies and gentlemen, they introduce me. I got to host the whole show. I'm walking out, like I'm coming out on the stage, and the crowd is just totally indifferent. As I'm walking out, a guy in the front row didn't yell it, wasn't mean. He just went like that, like as if he was a guy working in a museum. Like there's a Rembrandt, and that's a and there's a Picasso there. And so when he said it, the whole crowd was like, yeah! They just were so happy that the guy had said, and then as I kept walking toward the mic, like all the snot and everything just said, yeah, we're leaving. We're not, you're not, get off the, and I, so what I did was all I did was walk out and I said, your first comedian, and I said the guy's name, and then I just walked off to go. So that's all they, so now all I can think of is there must have been people in that audience that was their first time in a comedy club. So what they think a comedy club is they find some guy that's dying in a hospital and they make him go out on stage, and then a lumberjack in the front row goes and then everyone goes, yeah! And then he says the first comedian's name and they're going, I don't like comedy clubs. It's really, the two comedians were great, but making that sick guy go out and saying, you know, calling him, I thought that was awful, Or what's worse, there was a guy there going, comedy clubs are great. You go there, you tell some sick guy he's and then you watch two comedians. It's the best. Like, there's no good ending to that. It's all awful. It's all awful. So.